Now, let us begin our class with Brahmanad. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Good morning, children. In our today's class, we will discuss the lesson, The Open Window, Unit 1. But we will not cover the Unit 1 completely today. We will complete only half of this Unit 1 of the lesson, The Open Window. In our next video, we will continue the next part of Unit 1 of the lesson, The Open Window. It is written by Hector Hug Munro, who is famous in his pen name. And what is the pen name of Hector Hug Munro? The pen name of Hector Hug Munro is Shaki. So he is renowned in his pen name. Shaki is the pen name or pseudonym, or we can say an imaginary name of the writer Hector Hug Munro. Hector Hug Munro, who is well known in his pen name Shaki, is an eminent or famous English novelist and short story writer. His stories depict means what? Describe in words. His stories depict human behavior in interesting and playful situations and are remarkable for gentle humor. Humor, you know, full of fun and sparkling, shining knowledge, shining wit. Clear? So what have you understood about the writer? Hector Hug Munro is well known in his pen name. And what is the pen name of Hector Hug Munro? The pen name of Hector Hug Munro is Shaki. He is an eminent English novelist and short story writer. And what do his stories depict? His stories depict human behavior in interesting and playful situations, and his stories are remarkable for gentle humor and sparkling wit. This story is named as The Open Window because this story is completely based on The Open Window. So The Open Window has its relevance in this story. What is the setting of this story? The setting of this story is the drawing room of an upper class village house, and it was the house of Mrs. Shapleton. Clear? What did I ask you? What is the setting of this story? The setting of this story is the drawing room of an upper class village house. And who are the main characters of this story? The main characters of this story are Mr. Frampton Nuttall. Sometimes I will tell you Nuttall, or sometimes I will tell you also Frampton. But he is no other than Mr. Frampton Nuttall. Whether I say Nuttall or Frampton, you have to understand that that person is Mr. Frampton Nuttall. Second character is Vera. And who is Vera? Vera is the niece of Mrs. Shapleton. And what is her age? She is of 15 years of age. Clear? And the next character is Mrs. Shapleton, the lady of the house. Clear? Now, Let us go through the text. Phantom Nautel has no idea about Vera and Mrs. Sappleton. When Phantom Nautel went to the village of Mrs. Sappleton, he went to her house with a letter of introduction. Mr. Nautel means Mr. Phantom Nautel, is received by a young girl of 15. When Mr. Phantom Nautel went to the house of Mrs. Sappleton, he was received. Phantom Nautel was received by whom? By Vera. And who is Vera? Vera is the niece of Mrs. Sappleton, and she is 15 years of age. Mr. Nautel is received by a young girl of 15. When he calls on her aunt, when he means here Phantom Nautel, calls on means visits her aunt. Aunt of Vera is Mrs. Sappleton. When she comes to know that the guest knows nothing, when Vera comes to know that the guest, who is the guest of Mrs. Sappleton? Mr. Phantom Nautel. And when Vera comes to know that the guest knows nothing about her aunt, she decided to play a prank. Prank, you know, playful, trick or mischievous play. With whom? With the guest, Mr. Phantom Nautel. When Vera comes to know that the guest knows nothing about her aunt but her name and address. If Phantom Nautel knows anything about her aunt, he knows only about the name and address of her aunt, Mrs. Sappleton. When Vera comes to know that the guest knows nothing about her aunt but her name and address, the self-possessed young girl, here she self-possessed, calm and confident, self-possessed means, here it is written self-possessed, calm and confident, girl narrates an eerie tale, eerie means frightening or causing fear, tale or story, to whom? To the guest, Mr. Phantom Nautel, only to play a prank with him. So she decided to narrate an eerie tale of family tragedy to shock the highly strong visitor. Here highly strong means, you know, suffering from nervousness. Highly strong means nervous, suffering from nervousness. And actually Mr. Phantom Nautel was suffering from a disease. And what was the disease? That was the disease of highly strong. That was the disease of nervousness. He was suffering from nervousness. When he consulted the doctor advised him to go to a rural retreat so that he would recover from his illness. Now let us read the story and enjoy how the girl Vera befools the adults with her pranks. My aunt will be down presently. When Mr. Phantom Nautel reached the house of Mrs. Sappleton, he was received by Vera. And what did Vera say to Phantom Nautel? She said to Phantom Nautel that her aunt would come down presently. Presently means soon. She was in fact in an upstairs room when Phantom Nautel went to her house. She was not in downstairs. She was in upstairs. So who was in upstairs? When Mr. Frampton Nuttall went to the house of Mrs. Sappleton. When Mr. Frampton Nuttall went to the house of Mrs. Sappleton, Mrs. Sappleton was in an upstairs room. So he was said, Mr. Frampton Nuttall was said that Mrs. Sappleton would be down, would come to the downstairs soon. My aunt will be down presently, Mr. Nuttall said, a very self-possessed young lady of 15. Self-possessed, she was. Vera was a self-possessed, calm and quiet, confident lady of 15. In the meantime, you must try and put up with me. Put up with is a phrasal verb. And you know, put up with means tolerate. But here, put up with, that means accept somebody unpleasant. Put up with me. And remember, put up with means tolerate. Here, put up with me means accept somebody unpleasant, or put up means stay. You have to stay with me in the absence of my aunt, said Vera to whom? To Mr. Frampton Nuttall. My aunt will be down soon, said said Vera, a self-possessed young lady of 15. In the meantime, you must try and put up with me. Frampton Nuttall had never visited before the house of Mrs. Sappleton. So he endeavored means tried, E-N-D-E-A-V-O-R-E-D, endeavored means tried, he tried. Mr. Nuttall or Frampton Nuttall tried to say the correct something which should duly means properly flatter. Flatter, you know, false appreciation or false praise. Flatter the niece of the moment. The niece, that means Vera of the moment, without unduly. Unduly means improperly discounting. Here you see, discounting means taking into consideration. Discounting, taking into consideration beforehand. The aunt that was to come. That means when he reached, when Frampton Nuttall reached the drawing room of the house of Mrs. Sappleton, Mrs. Sappleton was in a room in upstairs, and he was saying that he would be down, she would be down soon. In the meantime, Mr. Frampton Nuttall had to stay with whom? With Vera, the young lady of 15, who was also the niece of Mrs. Sappleton. And he tried his best that would please the young lady, that is Vera. Privately, he doubted more than ever whether these formal visits on a succession of means in series, on a succession of means a series of total strangers would do much towards helping the nerve cure. Nerve cure means to get rid of the disease nervousness which he was supposed to be undergoing. Undergoing means suffering or taking place. Clear? So what is said here? Here it is said, when Mr. Frampton Nuttall visited the house of Mrs. Sappleton, it was the death anniversary of Mr. Sappleton. As it was the death anniversary of Mr. Sappleton, many visitors, many strangers would come the house of Mrs. Sepulton to console her. So he thought, Frampton Nuttall thought that he would have not visited the house of Mrs. Sepulton on that day because it was the death anniversary of Mr. Sepulton, and many strangers would come to the house of Mrs. Sepulton, and that would not help the visitor Frampton Nuttall to get rid of his nerve cure, that means get rid of nervousness. I know how it will be, his sister had said when he was preparing to migrate. Migrate, you know, migrate means shift from one place to another, to this rural retreat. Rural retreat means a safe and quiet place in a village or in a countryside. Rural retreat means a safe and quiet place in a countryside. When the sister of Frampton Nuttall came to know what he was said or what her brother was said by a doctor, she suggested her brother Mr. Frampton Nuttall to go to a quiet, safe and quiet place in a countryside in order to recover from his nervousness. I know how it will be, his sister had said when Nuttall was preparing to migrate to this rural retreat. You will bury yourself down. Bury yourself down means you get yourself bored without having any conversation with any one of the villagers. You will bury yourself down there, not to speak a living soul, a living person, and your nerves will be worse. Worse is the comparative degree of bad, and your nerves will be worse if you stay there unhappily without talking anybody in that rural retreat. Your nerves will be worse than ever from moping. Moping means what? In a dull state of mind. M-O-P-I-N-G. Moping means in a dull state of mind. If you remain in that village without talking anybody, then your nerves will be worse than ever from moping. I shall just give you letters of introduction. So the sister of Frampton Nuttall decided to give some letters of introduction to the people whom she had known in that village retreat. I shall give you letters of introduction to all the people I know there. Some of them means some of the villagers, some of the people of that rural retreat are very nice, are very good people, and they would be helpful to you in your time. Some of them, as far as I can remember, were quite nice. Some of the villagers, some of the people of that village known to the sister of Frampton Nuttall were quite nice people, were quite good people. Frampton wondered whether Mrs. Sepulton, the lady to whom he was presenting one of the letters of introduction, came into the nice division. Here nice division means nice people or people who are nice. Why had Frampton Nuttall gone to the house of Mrs. Sepulton? He had gone to the house of Mrs. Sepulton in order to hand over one of the letters of introduction given to her by his sister to be handed over to Mrs. Sepulton. In fact, he had gone to the house of Mrs. Sepulton to hand over a letter of introduction given to him by his sister. Clear? Now, sitting in the drawing room of Mrs. Sepulton, he was wondering whether the lady of the house, Mrs. Sepulton, whom he was going to hand over a letter of introduction, would come to be a nice person or nice division. Frampton wondered whether Mrs. Sepulton, the lady to whom he was presenting one of the letters of introduction, came into the nice division. That means came into the nice person. He didn't know anything about Mrs. Sepulton. At the same time, he also did not know anything about Vera. Now sitting in the drawing room of the house of Mrs. Sepulton, he was wondering whether the lady, Mrs. Sepulton, would come as a nice person to whom he was going to present a letter of introduction. Do you know any of the people round here? Meanwhile, Frampton Nuttall was asked a question by Vera, as Vera was also present in the drawing room, as it was she who received the guest, Mr. Frampton Nuttall, when he went to the house of Mrs. Sepulton. So what did Vera ask to Mr. Frampton Nuttall? She asked, "Do you know many of the people around here?" asked the niece when she judged. Here judged means considered. J-U-D-G-E-D. Judged means considered. When she considered that the guest knows nothing about her aunt, she asked, "Do you know many of the people round here?" asked the niece when she judged that they had sufficient silent communion. Here silent communion means silent thoughts or no conversation. When she judged and thought that there was a silent communion between the guest and herself for some minutes, she wanted to break the silence by asking a question. And how did she break the silence? She broke the silence by asking a question. And what did she ask to the guest? She asked the guest whether he knew many of the people round that place. Frampton answered, "Hardly a soul." And what was the reply of Frampton Nuttall when he was asked if he knew many of the people or many of the villagers round there? He answered that he had hardly known a single soul, means a single person round that place. Hardly, you know, scarcely. It means almost not. Hardly means almost not. He said he did not know any of the persons living round that place. "Hardly a soul," said Frampton. "My sister was staying here." And what more did he say to Vera? He said that his sister, eldest sister, was staying in that village. His sister was staying there. And he was staying at the rectory. Rectory, you know, a rectory means a house where the rector, Rector, you know, R-E-C-T-O-R. Rector means priest. A house where the priest of a church lives. Clear? What does rectory mean? Rectory means a dwelling place or a house where the rector, R-E-C-T-O-R, rector means priest of a church lives. So, he was giving more information about his sister to Vera. First of all, he said that his sister was staying there. He was staying at the rectory some four years before. His sister, Frampton Nuttall's sister, was staying in a house, in a rectory, that is a house where the priest of a church lives. And she gave me letters of introduction to some of the people here, as she is well acquainted with some of the villagers. She had sent some letters of introduction to be handed over to the people of this village. And she gave me letters of introduction to some of the people here. He made the last statement in a tone of distinct regret. And how did he make the last statement? He made the last statement in a voice or in a tone of clear, distinct regret, unhappiness. He made his last statement in a distinct regret, means in a clear unhappiness tone. He made the last statement in a tone of distinct regret. Thus, the niece of Mrs. Sappleton, Vera, came to know that the guest, Frampton Nuttall, didn't know anything about the village, didn't know anything about her aunt. If he knew her aunt, he knew her only by name and address, but he had never seen Mrs. Sappleton. Similarly, he had never been to that village before, so he had not known any of the persons living round in that village. "Then you know practically nothing about my aunt." Pursued means continued. P-U-R-S-U-E-D. Pursued means continued. The self-possessed. Self-possessed means calm and quiet young lady. She was a self-possessed young girl of 15. Who was a self-possessed young girl of 15? It was Vera, who was a self-possessed girl of 15. She was a calm and confident girl of 15. And she was the niece of Mrs. Sappleton. "Then you know practically nothing about my aunt," continued the self-possessed young lady. The caller admitted. Here, who is the caller? Here, the caller is Mr. Frampton Nuttall. Admitted, confess. And what did he admit or what did he confess? He confessed that he knew the aunt of Vera or Vera's aunt only by her name and address. Only her name and address, admitted the caller. He was wondering. At the same time, Mr. Frampton Nuttall was wondering whether the lady of the house, Mr. Sappleton, was in a married state or widowed state. Widowed, you know, a lady whose husband is dead. We call her a widow, W-I-D-O-W. And you know, what does we call a man whose wife is dead. If the wife of a person is dead, that person is called a widower. W-I-D-O-W-E-R. Understood? What does widow mean? A lady whose husband is dead. And what does widower mean? Widower means a man or a person whose wife is dead. In fact, he knew nothing about Mrs. Sappleton sitting in the drawing room of her house. He was wondering. And what was he wondering? Whether the lady of the house or Mr. Sappleton was in a married or widowed state. An undefinable means which is not definable, that is undefinable. An undefinable something about the room seemed, you know, appeared to suggest masculine habitation. And what does masculine habitation mean? Masculine habitation means living or dwelling of male members. So, not definable or describable about the room appeared to suggest the living of male members or living of men in that house. So, he was wondering whether Mr. Sappleton was in the married or widowed state. Now, let me ask you one or two questions. Why did Mr. Frampton Nuttall visit the house of Mrs. Sappleton? Mr. Nuttall visited the house of Mrs. Sappleton because he had to hand over a letter of introduction given to him by his sister. Clear? Why did Mr. Nuttall visit the village of Mrs. Sappleton? Mr. Nuttall was suffering from nervousness. He was advised by his doctor to migrate to a rural retreat so that he would recover to some extent from his illness. That was the reason why he visited the village of Mrs. Sappleton, thinking that would be the calm and quiet place and it would help, that the village would help him to recover from his illness. The remaining part of this unit we will go through in our next video. Thank you all.